we can't stress this enough, and so I'll just continue to repeat it. You can't look at trailing metrics and call a stock expensive, especially not a manufacturing-based cyclical business.
Nick, I feel like we haven't talked about KLA Corp in quite some time. It's time to do that.
It has been some time, and that's a real shame. We've been talking about the Fab Five a lot, though. So by default, if we're talking about the Fab Five, we're talking about, of course, KLA Corp. Let's get you up to speed.
Before we start talking about KLA, just want to remind everyone to check out our Semiconductor Insider membership. Just $5 a month gets you access to a whole host of goodies. Check our link in the description below. We have a promotion going on with Moomoo that gets you some bonus stocks, some extra cash, and a boost in your uninvested cash in your Moomoo account. So check out that link in the description below. It's a good deal. With that, let's talk about where KLA Corp fits into the semiconductor industry flow. Now, this company, as Nick mentioned, is in the Fab Five, five of the largest wafer fab packaging and assembly equipment companies out there. The other companies that fit into this space are ASML, Applied Materials, Lam Research, and Tokyo Electron. KLA is the smallest of the group, but you can see that it has a very vital role in the wafer fab equipment segmentation. They're the orange slice there. They specialize in process diagnostic control and metrology, measuring stuff.
Now, Casey put this chart together earlier this year, illustrating at a very high level the different processes involved in manufacturing chips. KLA's metrology and PDC is involved at every step of the process, everything from the actual development of the wafers themselves. Those are the big disks that you see people holding in a lab. They eventually get chopped up into chips and packaged into a computing or electronic system. Metrology is absolutely critical during all of these steps. It helps with quality control, and it also helps with the development of new manufacturing processes as well. Let's say a company like Taiwan Semi or Intel are working on their new manufacturing processes for next-gen chips, PVC equipment. Taking very, very small microscopic measurements is critical to make sure that the process cranks out the chip that was actually designed by the engineers.
There's a number of types of metrology and PDC, or process diagnostic and control. You can find a more in-depth explanation of each of these in our Onto video, as well as other metrology companies. Check that link out right here in the video.
Last month specifically, we did talk about Onto Innovation, and to a lesser but still important extent, Nova and Camtech. These are a few of KLA Corp's smaller competitors. And the reason why metrology and PDC is a potentially exciting segment of the manufacturing equipment space for semiconductors is we have, first of all of these new fabs, all these new chip manufacturing plants being constructed around the world. And those are going to need to be filled up with new equipment as they're completed. Here's some estimates from semi.org on number of new fabs coming online the next couple of years. For 200 millimeter wafers, that refers to the diameter of the actual wafers. And in tandem with that, a general increase in manufacturing capacity worldwide. We're going to get a nice uptick in that in 2025. But this last slide from semi.org is really interesting, because this is actually this is in reference to the 300 millimeter wafers. So 50% larger diameter wafers. These are the most advanced semiconductors, and the expected growth, especially in 2025 and 2026 in equipment, specifically for 300 millimeter wafers, is expected to ramp up quite high. And again, as I mentioned before, process diagnostic and control is a really, really critical piece of equipment when you're trying to figure out a new advanced manufacturing process. You can't set up a manufacturing line rife with error. Otherwise, you've just ruined billions of dollars worth of capital expenditure setting these fabs up. You have to get it dialed in right. That's where a company like KLA comes into play. Now, Casey, before we talk about the actual quarterly numbers, I want to tee this up because in some of our recent videos on the Fab Five, we've addressed some concerns that these stocks are expensive. So this is a chart to just kind of tee up this conversation around why maybe they're not nearly as expensive as they appear. At the time that we did the last update, KLA was at 43 times trailing 12-month earnings per share and at about 30 times 1 year forward expected earnings per share. Not a cheap stock. However, in light of those industry growth rates from semi.org I just showed you, we're expecting a big rally in KLA and the Fab Five in general, a big acceleration in their growth rates. All of this is sort of coalescing around the entire semiconductor industry, not just AI chips from the likes of NVIDIA, but the whole industry kind of coming out of the bear market and starting their next cycle of growth, currently the second half of 2024.
Created this chart with our friends from FinChat, illustrating KLA's performance during the downturn. You can see that they are off of their peak in total revenues, but their revenues have remained steady through the downturn. Their earnings per share and their free cash flow have remained profitable. Last quarter, which ended in June of this year, their revenue came in at $2.6 billion, which is up 9% year over year and quarter over quarter. Operating margin at 41%, still quite high, and earnings per share with sequential growth at $6.18. They ended up with $832 million in free cash flow in this quarter.
Before we talk about implications of this for the semiconductor market and pretty aggressive sell-off in chip stocks, a couple of things about their revenue. Nearly half of their sales come from actual wafer inspection equipment. That's a bit different from some of the metrology equipment that Onto Innovation provides. We own positions in both KLA and Onto Innovation. We view them as complementary. They do compete, but overall, we view them as complementary and part of a, let's just say, metrology and PDC holding in our portfolio. We treat them as kind of like one position in a way. At this particular juncture, China is also accounting for a very, very large piece of the pie, about 44% in the last quarter that ended in June. This should start to balance out as orders from fab customers pick up in Taiwan, Japan, the US, and elsewhere. But Casey, let's talk about implications for this market though, because we've been preaching now for really, I think, right when the downturn started, the fourth quarter of 2023, we said the expectation was the next upturn was going to start the second half of 2024. Is that what's happening? Is that starting to transpire?
Yes, what we expected for the second half of 2024 appears to be exactly what will happen. Taking a look at the September 2024 guidance, the revenue is expected to come in at $2.75 billion, plus or minus $150 million, which is up sequentially from $2.6 billion. So we're expecting to see a sequential growth and the earnings per share, a very significant sequential growth, up to $6.69, plus or minus 60 cents. It came in at $6.18. This most recent quarter. It certainly appears that the second half of this year is going to start to kick off on a high note.
So let's just bring this full circle here and talk about how expensive KLA core stock actually is and the Fab Five in general. We can't stress this enough. You can't look at trailing metrics and call a stock expensive, especially not a manufacturing-based cyclical business like KLA is. We are just at the very beginning of what could be a very aggressive two-year growth cycle. And so the valuation on a trailing 12-month basis is just simply not going to matter. Earnings are not slow and steady and up and to the right all the time. They've been in a downturn and they're now exiting that downturn. And so paired with the recent sell-off, KLA Corp now trading for roughly 28 times expected forward earnings. However, after this latest update from the company, Wall Street's probably going to be adjusting these expectations. And this thing may look more like somewhere in the mid 20s range for expected earnings per share on a one-year forward basis. So it's not as expensive as it looks. And this is including what's now roughly a 30% rally in the stock price so far this year. We got the sell-off, not just in KLA, but across all chip stocks in the semiconductor manufacturing equipment space. If you've been waiting for a more attractive entry price to get in, rather than doing a dollar cost average plan on these businesses, to us, this looks like a good buying opportunity, especially with these outlooks from management at KLA Corp indicating that the downturn is over and we are back in growth mode for the industry.
Before you exit out of this video, make sure you check out our Semiconductor Insider link below in the description, as well as our promotion that we have going on with Momo. Momo will get you some cool stuff, including 20 free stocks if you fund your account. You must use our Chipstock Investor link in the description to get these bonuses. Earnings season is just getting started, so we have a lot more coming your way. We'll see you very soon at Chipstock Investor.